guys, it's Sergey and this is episode number 3 of my weekly vlog. And unfortunately it's still not weekly. Unfortunately it took me more than 7 days to do this episode. And I'm not even sure that I'm going to edit it today. So it's like 8 or 9 days. I will do it in the near future, like on a more regular basis. Like I said, weekly, every 7 days. So it's going to be what I said, but now it's like a little bit off schedule. Good week, solid training again, not that much as I hope. Like I said before, I supposed to do like 2.5-3 hours of training every day, and now it's more like 1 hour, 2 hour maximum, which is a little bit upset for me. I still haven't started my swimming training. This is also a little bit upset. However, dynamic training and static quite nice. With the static, for the next 10 days my goal is to do 5:30, which is going to be my new personal best. So far it is 5:25. I done yesterday 5 minutes, which was okay, not really easy, but okay. So in the next 10 days I will try to do 5:30 or maybe even slightly bigger. So let's hope I will do it. With the dynamic, more or less the same. This morning I done 3 times 90 meters, actually 88. We have a strange pool, 22 meters, so I done 4 distances, which is like about 88 meters. Not easy, but not super difficult. So my current maximum with a dynamic B fins is 120, and I think to be able to do 3 times 90, I think I'm more or less ready for max 130. What do you think, guys? I think I'm ready, so I will try to do it. And static, static was okay. Depth training again, haven't managed a lot. I think done just a couple of times. FRC training, 26 meters. My goal for the next 10 days is to do a couple of times, like about 30 meters FRC, which is mouse feel as well. This is what I want to do before I'm going to go to Bali to workshop with Alexei Malchanov and Adam Stern. So guys, thank you very much for watching my videos. Please look, please have a look for the footage of my last week of training, of freediving training. Super tired, haven't been training, like real training. I mean training in a gym for a few months, I think about like 3 months. I was doing a lot of swimming, but it's not the same, not the same at all. Morning gym workout. This is my gym, and this is going to be my workout. By the way, this is my sandbag. I'm going to train with them, with this. Really nice workout, especially if you have a place like that as your backyard. One more thing to add. Why, when I snorkeling, every time I wearing the rash guard? It's like doesn't protect you from the losing your temperature. I mean, it's like 0.5 millimeters. It's not heat protection, but it is protection against small stuff like what can like bite you in the sea. Let's say now it was a lot of plankton. And like I finished a little bit earlier than expected because my neck start itching, and imagine if like my upper body is all open, then it's going to be all over itching. So that's why every time I wearing this rash guard. And why it's good to have this like bright color, because it's also easy to notice you on the surface. And this is why, for example, if any long tail, any small boats is moving around, it's better to have a bright color, then you can be easily noticed by any boat.